So volume will be given by integral 0 to 4, integral 0 to 3, 5 into 1 minus x by 3 dx dy. So first we need to integrate with respect to x here. So we'll get integral 0 to 4, 5 into integrate table, we'll get x minus x square by 6 and apply the limits from 0 to 3. So upon applying the limits, you'll get 5 into 3 minus 9 by 6 varum dy. So that is 5 into 9 by 6. Now integrate with respect to y, we'll get y limits are from 0 to 4. So we'll get 5 into 3 by 2 into 4. So the value is going to be equal to 30. So that is the required volume under the given surface. Now let us look at how to find the average value or mean value of a function. So if you are given a function y equal to f of x over closed interval ab, so its average value is given by 1 by b minus a into integral a to b f of x dx. Now when you come to the case of double integral, the average value of a function is defined as 1 by area of the region R into double integral over R f of x y dx. So this is the average of a function of one variable defined over closed interval ab, and this is the average of a function of two variable which is defined over a rectangular region. So f average will be 1 by area of the rectangular region into double integral over R f of x y dA. Now area of R is obtained by taking a length into width, so that will be b minus a into d minus c, that will be a of R, and we have already seen how to evaluate this integral. So this is how we evaluate the average of a function f of x. So let us look at an example of finding the average value. So we need to find the average value of f of xy equal to y sin xy over the rectangle 0 1 cross 0 pi by 2. So f average will be equal to 1 by area of R into double integral over R f of xy dA. Now area of R, that will be the area of the rectangle, so it will be 1 minus 0 into pi by 2 minus 0. So we'll get the area to be pi by 2. So therefore f average will be equal to 1 by pi by 2 double integral y sin xy. So let's take dx dy. So x will vary from 0 to 1 and y will vary from 0 to pi by 2. So we'll get 2 by pi integral 0 to pi by 2. So let's first integrate with respect to x. So when you integrate with respect to x, y will be considered as constant. Appo idu constant aayirikum. Sin xy derivative integral minus cos xy. Ni y constant aanu. Appo by y varum from 0 to 1 dy. So here both the y's will cancel off. So we will get minus 2 by pi integral 0 to pi by 2. Now apply the limits on x. So we will get cos x. Apply the limits on x cos y variable. So we will get cos y minus cos 0 is 1 dy. So integrate now with respect to y. So that will give minus 2 by pi. So integral of cos y is sin y minus y. Integral of 1 is y. Limits will be from 0 to pi by 2. So that will give minus 2 by pi. Sin pi by 2 is 1 minus pi by 2 at 0. Both the values are 0. So we will get minus 2 by pi. plus one will come. So therefore, f average will be equal to 1 minus 2 by pi. So that is the required value.